Hey everyone! Right now, Sony is focused on releasing spin-offs about Venom and Kraven the Hunter, as well as finishing Beyond the Spider-Verse. But now, Spider-Man 4 can be added to the list. The latest news indicate that the project has finally moved forward, and all the creators need to do is polish the script to perfection, find the right director...
Sam, I won't be spoken to in that manner.
You talking back to me?
And free up a slot on Marvel's busy release schedule. Let's start with the most interesting part. Sony and Marvel seem to have reached an agreement and buried the hatchet. Besides the fact that filming for Spider-Man 4 will begin in the fall, it's been revealed that the plot controversies have been supposedly resolved. Trustworthy insiders have confirmed that the central theme of Tom Holland's new Spider-Man solo movie will be loneliness, somewhat reminiscent of Matt Reeves' approach to his Batman films. So after the finale of No Way Home, Spider-Man will fully immerse himself in superhero activities, pushing Peter Parker's identity out of his life. Cut off from friends and the possibility of starting a happy family, Spidey will focus on eradicating all criminals in New York City. Considering that the hero will live only for this, one can imagine the fear of various criminal bosses. And here, as insiders believe, Kingpin will enter the arena.
I am not here to threaten you. I'm here to kill you.
With his grand plan to eliminate the spider threat. In the comics, this villain is known for using various thugs in his affairs, so everything seems to hint at what fans have been dreaming of for decades, Sinister Six. Interestingly, there is currently a scandal online over information that Zendaya will return in the fourth film. Moreover, her role will be so significant that there is a conflict between the production of Spider-Man and the Euphoria series. Allegedly, the creators of Spider-Man 4 had to bend over backwards just to get the actors to play in Marvel. If sources are to be believed, they managed to pull it off. But not all fans were pleased. Many believe that Zendaya's return with a significant role will eventually lead to her relationship with Peter Parker. This could potentially undermine the ending of No Way Home. Fans are demanding that Marvel introduce a new love interest in the new trilogy. I don't think Zendaya's return will necessarily devalue everything. It's all about how the character is used. Interesting love triangles could be introduced, adding a hefty dose of drama to the project, which aligns with Kevin Feige's stance on the project atmosphere. While many of us may want to see a grounded film where Spider-Man battles city mobsters, it's clear that after the Spider-Verse, a simple brawl with thugs is unlikely to draw mass audiences to theaters. Therefore, The Sinister Six is an excellent compromise. In this case, a grounded plot within New York City's criminal world can be maintained, while still approaching the scale of the previous movie. There have been many rumors and discussions about the long-awaited debut of The Sinister Six on screen.
Now then, Arachnid. Any last words?
Humana comes to mind.
Initially, The Sinister Six was planned as a standalone film within Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man universe. Then, this concept turned into a strange idea of a union between Vulture, Morbius, and other characters from the Sonyverse.
I've been reading about you.
I'm listening.
I'm not sure how I got here. Has to do with Spider-Man, I think.
Some claim that the post-credits scene in Morbius will be further developed in the upcoming Kraven the Hunter movie, while others say that the villains will have their own series of animated films in the style of Into the Spider-Verse. In any case, the beauty of the supervillain team is that studios can execute each idea simultaneously. While Sony works on its project, Marvel will involve its team in the fourth movie with Tom Holland. Now, fans immediately ask which villains will be part of the team within the MCU. The first and the most anticipated option is Scorpion, introduced back in 2017. He still hasn't had the chance to prove himself, and he has huge motivation to settle the score with Spidey, as he's still in prison due to the hero's actions. The next likely character will probably be Prowler. The character was also introduced in Homecoming, and back then, they laid the necessary background for him. Moreover, he appeared in the recent Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse, whose creators officially confirmed that he's the same version from the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Considering that insiders and producers have been teasing the debut of the live-action Miles Morales in the MCU for a really long time, his uncle could complement the story perfectly.
Yeah, sorry, Miles, I'm not gonna make it. Yeah, I'm just stuck.
Another potential member of the team is Mysterio. Yes, Quentin Beck will likely remain forgotten, and no one will resurrect him. However, both in the comics and in the animated series, the Great Deceiver had many imitators, from random fanatics to his own daughter, who made Mysterio's illusions more real using artifacts from Doctor Strange.
Mysterio is the master of the arcane art!
it!
Well, seems to me Mysterio is the master of talking about himself in the third person.
There were some hints at this in previous movies. Of course, if we analyze Holland's Spider-Man villain roster, it's still not enough for a complete Sinister Six. So either they create entirely new antagonists like Hobgoblin, or they utilize the fantastic opportunities of the multiverse. Judging by the latest insights, this detail became a key point of discussion in the new agreement between the studios. Sony Pictures insisted on including a multiverse element in the movie, and if we put the facts together, the filmmakers could easily leverage what's known as a glitch that moves Spider's villains from one universe to another. For example, in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, Morbius, Kraven the Hunter, Rhino, or Chameleon could end up. Of course, considering the failures of previous projects, it sounds ridiculous. However, projects like Loki, Across the Spider-Verse and Deadpool 3 have proven the viability of resurrecting even failed concepts. But what about Venom? If we recall the post-credit scene of No Way Home, before his teleportation, Eddie left a piece of Venom in the bar, and Brock's last wish was the opportunity to meet Spider-Man. It can be assumed that for the alien organism, this will become its main goal of existence, which will eventually lead us to the iconic black suit arc. From both a marketing and a logical standpoint, Venom's prequel could easily transition us to a new story about Tom Holland's Spider-Man. And in the spirit of the post-credits scene of Venom Let There Be Carnage, we'll shift to the Marvel Cinematic Universe, where will we see the fate of that particular piece of Venom. This also fits well with the overall concept of Spidey's current status, who has fully devoted himself to superhero life, and is forced to confront multiple supervillains simultaneously. Of course, much can still change, and it's entirely possible that creators will overhaul everything at the last minute, from the plot itself to the location of the film's action. Remember, according to the original plan, the creators of No Way Home wanted to make a film about the confrontation between Spider-Man and Kraven the Hunter. The coronavirus and other studio nuances forced a revision of the original plan, leading to the Spider-Verse with Tobey and Andrew. Despite all this, I'm sure the film will become a key project on the path to Avengers 5, and Spider-Man will become one of the main heroes of the multiverse saga culmination. Marvel now critically needs to pave the way for the next global crossover, and considering the mega popularity of the web-slinger, it's logical to expect Kevin Feige and his team to lay a significant foundation in the finale of the film. This could be either the appearance of Ant-Man asking for help to stop the looming threat, or even a bigger demonstration of reality breakdown due to multiversal machinations. By the way, if Spider-Man indeed dons the symbiote, then we should also expect that it is in this form that he will appear in the new Avengers. This would be an excellent opportunity to pay homage to the debut of the black suit in the comics and check up Tom Holland's portrayal, the once kind and soft character suddenly transforming into a ruthless and serious one. According to insiders, in the upcoming Secret Wars, we might indeed expect a meeting between Peter and Iron Man, played by Robert Downey Jr.
Don't do anything I would do, and definitely don't do anything I wouldn't do. There's a little gray area in there, and that's where you operate.
I think if you're a big fan of Tony Stark, this is great news for you. But yeah, my dear viewers, click on the like button, subscribe to the channel, and write what you think about it in the comments below. We'll see you soon.